In 1974, a low-budget Hindi film created ripples in the world of Indian cinema. At a time when the notion of good cinema was primarily associated with regional language films, this sensitive portrayal of feudal values and rural exploitation became a critical and commercial success.
दंडम दोरा, आप अंदर बैठो छोटे सा का, मैं सामान लेके आती हूँ।
अंकुर, the first feature film by Shyam Benegal, went on to win accolades and brought instant recognition to his extraordinary talent. Shyam Benegal's career, spanning over 15 years in feature films, coincides with an exciting period of the new Indian cinema. The films of Satyajit Ray, Mrinal Sen, and other regional directors created an ambience, an audience, which began to accept serious Indian films. For his part, Benegal avoided the self-consciousness of much of art cinema, concentrating instead on narrative communication, traversing what some critics called the path of the middle road cinema.
I grew up in Hyderabad. Hyderabad meaning actually in a cantonment town. There used to be the Secunderabad cantonment, which is a part of Hyderabad city. And my father was a still photographer. So that explains the family interest in photography and film and so on. Then too, there was a cousin now, Gurudat for instance. Gurudat was coming into films in those days. His career was a kind of inspiration. I would sort of very keenly listen to what he was doing whenever there was talk about Gurudat. And when he did come on holidays and things like that, my curiosity knew no end, you know. So that was how I think I was fired by this idea of wanting to become a filmmaker.
Benegal's technical skills as a film director were honed in the many advertising films he made in Bombay. He migrated to this metropolis, working first as a copywriter and then directing ad shorts and documentaries. But it was the Telangana peasant movement of the 40s and 50s which shaped Benegal's ideological stance. This rural uprising in Andhra Pradesh was the first major agrarian revolt of independent India.
That was part of my growing up. And it had a tremendous amount of impact. And I had a lot of people I knew who had participated. And when I went into college, some of these people were released from jail, you know. They were, many of them were jailed and so on. They were released from jail. And some became my classmates, as a matter of fact. They were part of my peer group, you know. So they had a tremendous amount of influence on me, particularly in the way I thought about the world, about the way things were moving, about society, Indian society, and so on and so forth.
The common theme in his early films was the class conflict in rural India, the changing power equations, and the challenge to feudalism. The director was responding to the social change around him.
तुम्हारा घर वाला है?
जी हो सरकार, मेरा मर्द है इन्हें।
क्या काम करता है?
काम सरकार कुछ भी नहीं करता, थोड़ा यत्ते बेगार कर लेता है।
तू क्या करती है?
मैं सरकार झाड़ू फाड़ का करती हूँ।
That was a direct result of the changing of the feudal system. Hyderabad was changing from a feudal system to what it has now become. The whole attitude, the whole concepts of people on the land, there was a kind of, you know, relationship between the people who worked in the fields and the person who owned land. all those changes started to take place about the time I was growing up, you know, and these relationships were changing. And that's directly related to all that, you know, the breakdown of feudal concepts, feudal values in many ways, and nothing to replace it that was either better than the feudal values that existed, which were terrible in any case.
In his next film, Nishant, Benegal repeated the theme of rural oppression, this time symbolized by the kidnapping of the schoolmaster's wife by the zamindars.
मैं जाती हूँ।
खालो बेटे, खाओ।
Whereas Ankur smoldered in its climax, Nishant explodes in an upheaval where the unleashed storm engulfs both the good and the bad. The social concerns, Benegal repeats time and again in his films, represent a commitment.
I feel that if you are with a medium, which is essentially a social medium, like the cinema is, whether you like it or not, it's a social medium. It's not a medium like a painter's medium. Because it is a social medium, somewhere along the line, a sense of social responsibility does creep into it, you know. You feel somehow responsible.
मैं तो देखूं तारी बात दिन न बीते नहीं रात कोने कहूं दिल्ली बात मैं तो था गिरे
The trilogy of Ankur, Nishant and Manthan are quintessential early Benegal. But it is in Manthan that he brings together the concerns of his earlier films in the story of the birth of a milk-producing cooperative. The conflict between the untouchables of the village and the rural vested comes to the fore in a film which was itself produced by 500,000 farmers of a Gujarat milk cooperative.
इस गांव के दूध उत्पादक सहकारी मंडली के नए प्रमुख हैं मोती
एक कभी नहीं हो सकता मैं जिंदगी में आज तक इलेक्शन नहीं हारा तुमने मारी इज्जत माटी में मिला दी तुम मारे को जानते नहीं हो डॉक्टर मेरी पंचायत में इलेक्शन में बड़े बड़े नेताओं भाषण देने आते हैं और तुम्हारी इस फटीचर सोसाइटी पद के लिए मेरी नाक कटवा दिया तुमने
मगर
गांव में पंचायत की बात चलती है तुम चाहते हो सोसाइटी पंचायत की जगिया ले ले ये नहीं हो सकता जाओ जाओ दोबारा पर्ची डालो और इस बार मेरा नाम आना चाहिए
An interesting aspect of Shyam Benegal's career has been the extraordinary number of young talents he has fostered. His filmography is studded with debuts by technicians and actors who moved out of his shadow to become major talents in their own right. Govind Nihilani, his cameraman for the early films, Shabana Azmi, Smita Patil, Nasiruddin Shah, Om Puri, Kulbhushan Kharbanda.
Once you know your actors, once you know all the members of your unit, you know, where you're not changing people around all the time, it's easier to get everybody locked into the same kind of consciousness, you know. And it helps because it saves on time. You have a much more precise manner of communicating with each other. And in addition to that, you know that everybody is going in the same direction as you have planned. People are not have not misunderstood the signals, you know, because that often happens in films. You can have actors making their own film, acting in a film that is not necessarily the film that is being made.
In 1988, Shyam Benegal set to work on a major television serial, Bharat Ek Khoj, and documenting him at work was the cinematographer of his early films, Govind Nihlani.
As a director, he does not treat you only as a person doing a particular job. Most of his films have been shot on location, where the entire unit goes and lives on the location. And a feeling of togetherness grows, because you have breakfast together, you travel together, then you shoot together, you come back together, you have dinner together, and then you chat and you celebrate, because invariably in Shyam's unit you have several birthdays coming. And everybody, you know, has his little party, little celebration. That contributes a lot to creating this tremendous family feeling.
In Ankur, Shyam was assisted by a technical team which was largely uninitiated to feature films, and he cast a young Film Institute graduate in the lead role. Shabana Azmi went on to win the National Award for Best Actress that year.
As far as the main part is concerned, Shabana's part was very interesting, because you see, the first person I had asked was Wahida, because I could see Wahida in my mind for that particular part. She said yes in the beginning, but later on she wasn't sure she could do it, so she said no. So that sent me into a tizzy, and I asked several other people, among whom were Sharda, you know, from the south, who was not sure whether she could speak Hindi well enough or Dakhni well enough. Then I asked Aparna. Even she wasn't very sure, and eventually said no. And while this was going on, I had this girl come from the Film Institute.
He just looked at me without looking at the photographs, and within 5 minutes he said, "You're going to do Ankur, and there's also going to be, this is going to be followed up by a sequel called Nishant, and you're going to do that as well." I couldn't quite believe that. And then he had a look at my photographs and sort of hummed and hawed and said, "Well, I think we'll leave these photographs alone and I'll take another photographic session." And I came home and I told my mother, "I just met some fraud guy who says I'm going to be in two films." And of course it doesn't mean anything, because he hardly asked me any questions at all. And then 15 days later, there was this script in my house. And before I knew it, in 18 days exactly, on the 18th of August, 1973, I think we went. And we completed the film on the 18th of September.
The difference between a good actor and not so good an actor, I think, is their own insights into a part. And most of these people are extremely insightful actors and actresses. The last scene in Ankur with Shabana, I spoke to her at length about some scene I remember in a newsreel that I had seen, you know, during the Bangladesh war, where there was this woman who lost her entire family, and she was crying inconsolably. You know, I said, this is it's a kind of limit to which you come to, you know.
All along I knew that this was my important scene and everything depended on that scene. And at the time that I was supposed to perform it, I went into a complete blank and I would feel absolutely no emotion at all. And I thought, this was it. I mean, this is just gone. And Shyam saw me, and he saw me in that state, and he said, "You can just go and take some time." He got Govind to set the camera completely. And I just sat there absolutely cold, and I said, "I can't do it, because I feel absolutely nothing." And I'd done it in my mind several times, and it had hit me each time, and it was strange that this had happened. And he just came to me, and he didn't speak about this particular scene at all. He said, he started talking to me, I remember, about a Bangladesh refugee. And I had seen that film, I think it was Subdev's film or something like that. And he just started talking to me about her. As I'm telling you this, I'm getting goose flesh. And I remember being very, very moved by it. And he saw me and he said, all right, she's ready. And he just took me in front of the camera, and that's how it worked.
मारा तूने आराम के जने क्यों मारा माटी मिले इन्हें मुंह नहीं तो बाबा काम मांगने आया था इसको मारा तेरे दिल में काला था इस वास्ते डरा ना तू तेरी शान मिट्टी में मिले तू बढ़ा दी अपने घर का होएगा समझे हम तेरे खरीदे गुलाम नहीं है अब को तेरा काम नहीं होना तेरा पैसा नहीं होना तेरा कुछ नहीं होना सब अपने मुर्दे के साथ लेगा तू मेरे मर्द को मारा तेरे को परमात्मा की मार पड़ेगी तू कभी नहीं बन पेगा तूने गरीबों की हार ली है ना तू कभी नहीं बन पेगा
What I like about Shyam is that he never attempts to translate for the actor, which is a quality of a great director. Otherwise, one tends to, because it's easier to explain, instead of explaining the background to the actor, give him a gesture. Now, sometimes he does that with non-actors or with children, but otherwise, he arouses the feelings in you by explaining the background and therefore giving also respect to the actors and allowing them to create themselves. Because whatever eventually, if you copy a gesture told by the director, at best what you can do is you can copy that. It won't be your own.
यदि वो अलग अलग समूह में बंटकर अलग अलग स्थानों से हम पर आक्रमण करेंगे तो हम उन्हें पराजित नहीं कर पाएंगे और महाराज कलिंग की प्रजा उन्हें शरण देना पुण्य का काम
समझती है तो यहां पे ये
बहुत ठीक है द आइडिया इज टू फाइट द बैटल अकॉर्डिंग टू आवर टर्म्स जो अंग्रेजी में लिखा था करेक्ट था ऑन आवर टर्म्स नॉट ऑन आवर बॉर्डर
अच्छा व्हाट इज दैट लाइन हियर
With a large filmography to his credit, 15 feature films and documentaries, in most of his films, Shyam Benegal works with gifted collaborators on the script, synthesizing from their contributions his own particular worldview and sensibility.
Junoon was based on The Flight of Pigeons, which was written by Ruskin Bond, but Ankur was my own story and script. So was Trikal, my own story and script. But Junoon's script was mine. So I've written scripts without collaborators as well. But most of my other films have always had collaborators or direct writers. You know, there've been a combination of writers or there's just been one writer.
यदि प्रजा और राज्य की रक्षा नहीं कर सकता, तो उसे राज्य सिंहासन पर बैठने का कोई अधिकार नहीं।
ऐसा लगता है आप सुशीला से घृणा करते हैं।
हाँ।
We have how much dialogue on that?
That is only from this chakra. The main part is the chakra view tournament.
Yeah, so yeah. Waha se.
And that is KK's back long shot. So
it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Because we've seen him for so long.
And I see the feeling of conspiracy.
Yeah, will become. So that you have to leave them in some isolation.
उसने भारी सभा में मेरे सिर पर चपत मार दी. क्या? हाँ. सबके सामने.
If I can help it, I wouldn't like to. Leave the decisions, the creative decisions, to the editing table. I'd like to see that what I shoot is edited the way I have shot it and meant to be edited. Now this does happen. Most of the times this does happen, but there are some sequences, certain kinds of things where you may have also conceived it not as clearly when you were shooting it. So when you have sequences like that, then of course a lot of the damage has to be corrected on the editing table.
Good night.
चल चल आगे ले लो, हटो हटो, चलो भाग जाओ।
सुनिए, आपने हमारी उषा जी का डांस देखा?
In Bhumika, Benegal moved from the rural exploitation theme to a study of the woman. The film, based on the life of Marathi actress Hansa Vadkar, came to symbolize the technical excellence and narrative skill of the director.
In terms of technique and so on, all its flashbacks, flash forwards, change of colors, you know, change of stocks, in fact, used as part of interpretation. Because I used all kinds of things in that. I used black and white, then tinted black and white, you know, different kinds of tints, like sepia, green, blue, amber, all sorts of things like that. Plus, I used the very old stock, like, you know, Gewa color, the first Gewa color stock that came to India in the monopack system. Then also Orwo, and then Eastman. In the manner in which these stocks had come to India, you know, within the film industry itself. So this was one of the things I did with Bhumika, but it didn't seem to me that Bhumika was a very complicated project.
Bhumika was particularly exciting because there we were dealing with four distinct periods of evolution of Indian cinema, and with it the evolution of cinematic style, the cinematographic style of those periods. We went to the Film Institute archives and had a look at several films of various periods and studied their lighting styles, studied their compositions, and tried to incorporate them in the film, which was a very challenging, at the same time very satisfying experience.
तुम मेरे क्रोध को नहीं जानती, मेरे इस अग्नि महल से आज तक कोई भी कुमारी जिंदा नहीं बच सकी है, मैं तुम्हारे सौंदर्य को जलाकर राख कर दूंगा, अग्नि।
It was also in this film that he drew out a brilliant performance from Smita Patil, in what was only her third film and her second major role.
कखन को कुरेद कुरेद
डायलॉग बोलने की जरूरत नहीं है। उस बार घर ले आया था, बार बार नहीं लाऊंगा।
तो मरने क्यों नहीं दिया मुझे, क्यों वापस ले आए?
गलती की।
मेरी कमाल की जरूरत है इसीलिए ना।
तुम्हारे बिन जीना लगे घर में बलम जी, तुमसे मिला के अखिया, बलम जी तुमसे मिला के अखिया, तुम्हारे बिन
Smita was not a trained actress. With her, the approach had to be different. You know, her Bhumika part, for instance, I had been talking to her for about 6 months. Through the time we were shooting Manthan, after that, then we had all gone off to Cannes Film Festival with Nishant. I was talking to her in Cannes about it, in Paris about it, in London about it, back in Bombay again, and going on and on and on and on like this, because at that time I had this feeling that she wasn't quite serious about her position as an actress. I felt that she hadn't quite made her commitment to the profession. She had to go through all kinds of things, you know, well before we started shooting the film. And I felt it was necessary for her to go through all this. She used to go for dancing lessons to Khar every day for 2 or 3 hours. Then early in the morning, she had to wake up and go for her riding lessons. Then she had to come and do her fencing lessons. So I used to keep her completely occupied for about 8 or 9 hours of the day, you know, only to keep her focus from shifting. This really had very little to do with what she actually did in the film.
Duniya mere kadam chumti hai, par mere ek ishare par duniya tumhare kadam chumegi.
मेरी मोहब्बत को कबूल करो उषा।
उषा तुम
क्या हुआ?
कट कट कट।
Shyam Benegal's subsequent partnership with Shashi Kapoor realized his most stylish period. Junoon was based on a short story by Ruskin Bond, A Flight of the Pigeons.
لعنت ہے ان کبوتروں پر خبیث مکروہ دوزخی پرندے ان کی تحریری میں ہمارے سپاہیوں کی موت لکھی ہے ہزار بار لعنت ہے ان پر ابلیس کی اولاد دیکھنا حرام ہے
رک جاؤ
چھوڑیے مجھے
رک جاؤ نہیں تو میں تمہیں جان سے مار ڈالوں گا
انہیں بچانے کے لیے آپ مجھ پر ہاتھ اٹھائیں گے ملک کے لیے نہیں इन्हीं खुद खर्जियों ने तो हमें दगा दिया जावेद भाई हम दिल्ली हार गए हैं
टू क्रिएट अ सेंस ऑफ पीरियड यू हैव टू फॉल ऑन सर्टेन काइंड्स ऑफ स्कीम्स व्हिच मेक्स पीपल फील दैट दे हैव बीन ट्रांसपोर्टेड इनटू दैट सेंचुरी और दैट पर्टिकुलर पीरियड विद इन द सेम सेंचुरी इनटू दैट डेकेड और व्हाटएवर नाउ इन दिस केस द होल एम्फेसिस was to create a certain kind of warmth in the color schemes.
We were trying to deal with a period which has been documented very well in lithographs, in prints, you know, the British period. And we didn't want to totally follow that style. Yet, since the period has become identified with those visual representations, we didn't want to move away from it either. So we tried to find a balance between the two. And I think that worked out very, very well.
But Junoon is more than just style and polish. The obsessive love of a Pathan soldier for an English girl is set against the tragic backdrop of the 1857 Sepoy Mutiny. In the understated, quiet tone of the film, Benegal avoids major compromises to popular cinema.
इश्क ने तोड़ी सर पे कयामत जोरे कयामत क्या कही सुनने वाला कोई नहीं रुदा दे
It's your own sensibility, your reaction to something, to a story or whatever. I do use melodrama, but I use it when it is credible, not when it is incredible.
The stylishness of Junoon and Kalyug was further extended by Benegal in a film he made in 1986. Trikal is set in the liberation days of Goa. It moves backwards and forwards between time planes and captures exquisitely the social and political ambience.
In this particular house, this kind of the house it was, the kind of color scheme that was worked out for it, based on what it was like when people actually lived in that house, you know, about 30 or 40 years before. Nitish had worked out the schemes based on the motifs that the house actually had. And once we had worked out all those color schemes, we felt that if we were going to shoot night sequences in this place, then it would be wonderful to try and shoot in with oil lamps. Now, that wasn't very practical. So what we did was we said we can shoot in candlelight. Now, we had 400 ASF film. It was possible to do that. So Ashok did a few tests. And once those tests were done, we found that we could expose and we could get the kind of depth we wanted by using certain kind of candles. So all the night sequences in the film were shot actually in candlelight, except to use HMI lights for, you know, to give a certain kind of depth in the landscape. You know, you get a certain moonlit quality and so on and so forth. But in the interiors and for the characters, we had nothing but candles to light them up.
जाओ बेटा। डॉक्टर परेरा, मुझे लगता है ये सब अफवाहें हैं।
नहीं, अफवाहें नहीं हैं। पुल और सरकारी इमारतों के आसपास बारूद जमा किया जा रहा है। इंडियन आर्मी आएगी तो पोर्चुगीज सरकार सब कुछ उड़ा देगी, पूरा गोवा जलेगा।
डॉक्टर परेरा की फूल मालाएं तैयार हैं इंडियन आर्मी के लिए।
Once again, the visual approach Benegal employs complements the nostalgic recreation of a period which is coming to an end in a subdued but effective manner.
Was very important for that film was to get the character of languidity, you know. Life in that sort of situation is a little more languid, certainly on the surface. And to get that, I needed a certain fluid kind of style. So we used a lot of the spider dolly and we had these very long takes. We didn't cut too much when we were shooting our sequences, all the staging of the scenes. We're done in a manner where we wouldn't keep chop, 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 chop all the time. And Bhumika were not, they were narratives. At base is a narrative, a skeletal structure on which you have to place something on. But the plot is not necessarily of great importance to me. People are, characters are, you know. What emerges, what changes? I'm more interested in looking at the process. Because process is probably the most elusive thing to register. You can register a pre-changed and a changed condition, but the process of change itself is very difficult to register, and it's fascinating to look at this. It's much like shadow of the sun, you know, when the lengthening of shadows. You don't see the shadows actually lengthening. You see it when it has lengthened, or when the shadow is short.
This process of change has been documented time and again in Benegal's films. In Sussman, he studies the impact of the coming of the power looms and the modern textile buyers into the world of the traditional weavers. Although the film was not enthusiastically received, it remains, in terms of its sensitivities, consistent with his concern for the rural poor.
चलो करके पे बैठेगा तो टांगा तोड़ दूंगा तेरी।
ऐसा काइकू बोल रहे हैं, एक तो भी दिन बैठना ही चाहिए उसको करके पर।
इन्हें नहीं बैठेगा करके पर, पढ़ लिख को बड़ा आदमी बनेगा। मैं ही मेरे बेटे को बंद नहीं करूंगा इस पिंजरे में।
तो क्या बीमा के वैसा बनाएंगे, ना घर का ना घाट का?
In 1982, Shyam Benegal made a film financed by the West Bengal government. Arohan typifies the social commitment which has dominated his films. A commitment which is not the polemical stand of an activist, but the vision of a poet, capturing the charm that rural poverty and oppression bring in their wake. In the last few years, Benegal has made major documentaries. First, a feature-length film on Satyajit Ray, followed by a co-production with the Russians on Jawaharlal Nehru. Bharat Ek Khoj. The serial is an ambitious recreation of Indian culture and history and is based on the book Discovery of India by Pandit Nehru. Those familiar with his body of work insist that Benegal's films have been distinguished by an effort to reach out to a larger audience. He has done this without compromising his sensibilities or trivializing his own concerns as a filmmaker. In doing so, he has evolved a bridge between art and popular cinema. This perhaps is his major contribution as an artist to the world of Indian cinema.